Hi, this is Lacey Kwasnicki.
And Lauren Burdick, Senior Instructional Specialist from the Office for Teaching and Learning.
We know you have all been working diligently through the process of planning and preparing your schools for the 2013-14 school year, and would like to take this opportunity to provide you with information and updates from the Office for Teaching and Learning. Our elementary curriculum team has collaborated closely to align our efforts across English language arts, math, science, and social studies to provide a consistent approach to curriculum and instruction for the upcoming year. With this podcast, we aim to make connections between contents, identify focus areas, discuss goals for professional learning, and outline resources and supports that will be available for teachers and schools. Pasco's integrated system will provide the framework for our work K through 12 as we implement our district focus areas of standards-based instruction, professional growth, and professional learning. PLCs will serve as the vehicle for teachers to study their standards and increase effectiveness in order to impact student learning. Since the work of the PLC will be to plan for and respond to student learning, teams will collaboratively work through the five guiding questions, beginning with question number one, what do we expect all students to learn? In this step, teams will unwrap Common Core standards in order to set learning goals. To know if and when students have learned, question number two, teams will collaborate to create scales for student-owned progress monitoring. The next step for the PLC will be to make instructional decisions and anticipate how to meet the needs of all students. There has been some district work that will impact and assist PLCs to begin the process of unwrapping standards. Teams of teacher leaders in math and English language arts from across the district have collaborated to identify and group Common Core standards for preliminary unit planning. The Office for Teaching and Learning has a goal to provide curricular support and resources to all of our elementary schools to assist in achieving a viable curriculum across schools. Teachers can expect to receive a roadmap for instruction, which outlines groups of Common Core standards organized into instructional units. Along with the grouping of standards, a multidimensional unit scale will be provided as a resource for teachers to use to unpack the unit. Recommendations for pacing, suggested resources, sample tasks, and sample unidimensional lesson scales with modeled unwrapping of standards will also be provided.
In science, teachers will continue to teach the next generation Sunshine State standards and utilize the same curriculum maps for this year that will provide general grade level correlations to the Common Core state standards. They will also be provided with a tool outlining the vertical progression of topics for big ideas to support planning, along with multi-dimensional scales for the nature of science. Recommendations for inquiry investigations and engineering design challenges that foster problem-solving, discovery, and exploratory learning opportunities will also be provided. Teachers can anticipate access to curriculum resources for ELA, math, and science via Canvas by August 2nd.
Our prioritized shifts for ELA include writing to sources, text-based answers, and evidence-based discussions through a staircase of complexity. Our students should demonstrate independence reading, writing, and speaking about increasingly complex, grade-appropriate text, drawing on evidence to support their thinking. Additionally, students should be able to write for a variety of audiences and purposes, using text evidence to support arguments and critique reasoning of others.
The implementation of the mathematical practices will promote the integration of these prioritized instructional shifts into daily teaching. Practices such as making sense of problems and persevering in solving them, constructing viable arguments and critiquing the reasoning of others, and attending to precision will result in instruction that will ensure students have a deep understanding of mathematics they are doing. Not just learn the procedure or trick, but to fully understand why those procedures or tricks work. We also want students to have opportunities to apply the mathematics they are learning to the real world through dual intensity in practice and understanding.
In alignment with the prioritized shifts for ELA and math, and to delve deeper with implementation of the Common Core within a PLC, we have set goals for professional learning for the 2013-14 school year. These goals are part of a much larger multi-year plan that we will continue to build and modify over time. Pacing for professional learning is estimated and will be adjusted based on the needs of our teachers and schools. Your role in the professional development of teachers is critical, and we are looking forward to collaborating with you through an ongoing feedback loop to support our teachers with job-embedded learning within their PLCs. For Semester 1, professional development will focus on intentional planning that will transcend all content areas and lead to intentional teaching and learning. Teams will build a common language of instruction by deepening their knowledge with the instructional framework. Specifically, teachers will learn how to design and use learning skills, build standards-based units of instruction, and develop rigorous and relevant learning tasks to use in their classroom. Building on the work of Semester 1, Semester 2's focus for ELA will help teachers define rigor as they work to create relevant tasks using increasingly complex grade-appropriate text. Specifically, teachers will learn strategies to help students find text evidence to support their views, engage in evidence-based discussions, and write for a variety of purposes and audiences. Feedback gathered from teachers and administrators at all 46 elementary schools indicated a need for a common tool to guide instructional decisions and align instruction to our new rigorous set of standards. Additionally, 2012-13 outcomes for kindergarten and first grade indicate the need for additional support for students to meet expectations for increased rigor in later grades. We have identified professional learning goals specific to K-1 teachers that address foundational skills in connection with reading comprehension. Teacher learning has already begun this summer with an overview of the Independent Reading Level Assessment, IRLA, and will continue to take place throughout the year. Specifically, teacher learning will focus on coaching and conferencing, characteristics of grade-appropriate text, designing rigorous foundational and comprehension lessons, and engaging students in evidence-based discussions. You'll notice that many of the goals in the K-1 learning plan parallel those for grades 2 through 5. However, the pacing is adjusted to accelerate learning. This is very intentional and provides teachers time for the implementation of the IRLA, and how it supports daily instruction for individuals, small groups, and the whole class.
To build the knowledge of teachers, PLC facilitators, coaches, and leaders, we will utilize a mix of blended and face-to-face learning opportunities. We plan to launch our Office for Teaching and Learning Canvas site on August 2nd, which will house a variety of resources to support the work of the PLC, including curriculum resources, videos of model lessons, and periodic podcasts to facilitate learning.
Weekly professional development will be directly linked to the integrated literacy block and will be designed for all teachers to meet the needs of their students. Professional learning should be embedded within PLCs and help teachers build their collective knowledge about the Common Core State Standards and Next Generation Sunshine State Standards to clarify what students must know, understand, and be able to do as a result of each unit of instruction. MMH Treasures will continue to serve as our core reading program for use within the integrated literacy block as outlined in the K-12 plan. This year, we are working to redefine Treasures as an instructional resource. Additional resources, specifically content text, should be integrated into the literacy block. We are providing teachers with the necessary resources to select coordinating text specific to science and social studies.
HMH Go Math will continue to serve as the primary mathematics resource, and teachers have access to benchmark assessments in an item bank for more frequent assessments to track student progress. New changes to Think Central will allow teachers to choose items and create their own common assessments. The focus for math will be on the implementation of the standards for mathematical practice while teaching the Common Core State Standards.
We are continuing to look at the feedback we receive from teachers and administrators regarding assessments in order to maximize teaching time and identify tools that will provide teachers with data they can use to drive instruction. In connection to our prioritized shift of writing to sources, we are also working to revise the writing rubrics for grades K through 5. These will be available for teachers via Canvas by Planning Week.
We welcome your questions, clarifications, and requests for school-based support. Please feel free to contact us so we can help meet the needs of your school and exceed your expectations.
We are looking forward to a great start to the 2013-14 school year.